हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ शिखा. नाउ इट्स टाइम टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच प्रोनाउन. लेट्स सी इट्स टाइप एंड एग्जांपल्स. डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रोनाउन: एनी ऑफ अ स्मॉल सेट ऑफ वर्ड्स इन अ लैंग्वेज दैट आर यूज्ड एज सब्स्टिट्यूट्स फॉर नाउन और नाउन फ्रेजेस एंड हुज रेफरेंस आर नेम्ड और अंडरस्टूड इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. So, if we are using any words at the place of noun or noun phrases in a sentence, those words are called pronouns. See the example: Michael is a good boy. He gets up early in the morning. Here, you don't have to mention Michael again. Here, in this example, we are having two sentences and both are related with one boy. So, at first time, we have mentioned the name of the boy, and in second sentence, we have used a pronoun that is suitable for the name of that boy. Next example is: the coach selected several key points. He wanted the team to memorize them. He replaces coach and them replaces several key points. Here there is no need to use coach again. We have used he at the place of coach and we have used them at the place of several key points. So he and them will be pronoun. See the use of different types of pronoun: personal pronouns like he, they; demonstrative pronouns like this, these; interrogative pronouns are which, who; indefinite pronouns like none, several; possessive pronouns like his, your; reciprocal pronoun like each other, one another; relative pronouns like which, where; reflexive pronouns like itself, himself; and intensive pronouns are itself and himself. Now let's see each of the type of pronoun in detail. Personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are short words used to represent people or things. The personal pronouns are I, you, he, she, it, we, and they. They are primarily used to avoid repetition. So main function of personal pronouns is to minimize the repetition of noun in a sentence. Look at this example: Myra, that is David's kitten, looks cute, but he thinks she is evil. So the personal pronouns he and she avoid the need to repeat David and kitten. Here is a table showing personal pronouns by case and person, that how they relate to a speaker and used in a sentence. The table includes person, subjective case, objective case, possessive determiner, possessive pronouns, reflexive pronouns according to the category of person. So first person singular category contains the subjective case as I, objective case me, possessive determiner my, possessive pronouns mine, and reflexive pronouns myself. Now second person singular category contains you, you, your, yours, and yourself. Third person singular category contains he, she, it; him, her, it; his, her, its; his, hers. We are not having the possessive pronoun of it category. And then himself, herself, and itself in reflexive pronoun. Now first person plural category, we include we, us, our, ours, and ourselves. Second person plural category comes you, you, your, yours, and yourselves. And third person plural category contain they, them, their, theirs, and themselves. You need to remember or learn this table for the proper use of different type of pronoun in a sentence. As per this table, the personal pronouns are categorized by person. There are three person categories: first, second, and third. Now let's see how these categories are all about. First person, the first person personal pronouns I and we represent those who are speaking. Means first person category contains those people who are speaking, means the speaker. Second person personal pronouns you singular and you plural represent those being addressed, means to whom you are speaking. The listener will be the second person, that includes you in singular as well as in plural. Now, third person personal pronouns contains he, she, it, and they, and they represent those who are neither speaking or nor being addressed. Means everybody else. Means about whom you are talking. One is the speaker, that is first person. One is the listener, that is second person. And the third person will be about whom you are talking. Different type of personal pronouns based on how they are used. So they are categorized as one of the following. First is subjective personal pronoun. I, you, he, she, it, we, and they are the subjective personal pronouns. These are the versions used for the subjects of verb. So these are the pronouns used as a subject of verb in a sentence. For example, you are happy. They won the league. Now in both of the sentences, you and they both are pronouns and act as a subject in this sentence. So they will become subjective personal pronoun. So subjective personal pronouns are ones in a subjective case in a sentence. Like, give a girl the right shoes and she can conquer the world. It's a saying by actress Marilyn Monroe. And in this sentence, she is acting as a subjective personal pronoun. Next is, we are what we believe we are. It's again a saying by author C.S. Lewis. And in this sentence, we is a pronoun, comes thrice in a single sentence in the form of subjective personal pronoun. Next type of personal pronoun is objective personal pronoun. The objective personal pronouns are me, you, him, her, it, us, and them. These are the versions used when the personal pronouns are objects of different kind, like direct objects, indirect objects, or objects of prepositions. So when the personal pronouns are coming at the place of object in a sentence, it will be said objective personal pronoun. For example, Paul knows her. Here, personal pronoun her is a direct object. Now, what is direct object? Direct object is related with the verb of the sentence. Here, her is related with verb knows. So, it will be a direct objective personal pronoun. Next is, Paul gave them the letter. Here, personal pronoun them is an indirect object. Now, what is an indirect object? The direct object is related with the verb of a sentence and indirect object is related with the direct object. Here, the letter is direct object and them is related with the letter. So, it is playing as an indirect objective personal pronoun. Next is, Paul went with him. Here, the personal pronoun him is an object of a preposition. Now, in this sentence, you can see a preposition with. And him is a kind of personal pronoun that is coming at the place of object after the preposition. So, it will be an example of the personal pronoun that is used as an object of a preposition. So, objective personal pronouns are ones in an objective case in a sentence. Now, some more example in the form of saying by famous authors. First is, get the facts first, then distort them. Now, them is coming at the place of object and it is related with the verb distort. So, it will be an example of the direct objective personal pronoun. And it is a saying by American author Mark Twain. Now, next is again a saying by Henry Fielding. Conscience is the only incorruptible thing about us. Now, in this sentence here, you can see about is a type of preposition and us is a personal pronoun coming at the place of object after the preposition. So, it will be an example of the personal pronoun used as an object of a preposition. Came to next type, possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns are used to show possession. The possessive pronouns are mine, yours, his, hers, ours, and theirs. So when somebody wants to show the possession of someone on something, we use possessive pronouns. Some examples, the tickets are as good as ours. Shall we take yours or theirs? In these sentences, ours, yours, or theirs, they are possessive pronouns that are showing possession of someone on something.
These pronouns are sometimes called absolute possessive pronouns to differentiate them from possessive determiners that are my, your, his, her, its, our, and their, which are also classified as a type of possessive pronouns. Means the previous examples like mine, yours, his, hers, ours, and theirs, they are called absolute possessive pronoun, whereas my, your, his, her, its, our, and their, they are classified as possessive determiners also. Now see the example. This is Sarah's English book. Have you seen her French book? In this example, the pronoun her replaces Sarah's. Means her is a type of possessive pronoun that is showing the possession of Sarah on her French book. Now this example can also be written like, this is Sarah's English book. Have you seen hers? Now hers will be an absolute possessive pronoun that is showing Sarah's possession on her English book.
Here is a chart that is showing how the possessive pronouns are made. For the subject I, which is having the adjective my, possessive will be mine for that. For you, adjective will be your and possessive pronoun will be yours. For he, adjective will be his and both will be used as a possessive pronoun his. She will be subject, her will be adjective of she, and hers will be the possessive pronoun for she. It is a subject, its adjective, and there is no possessive for it we are going to use as a pronoun. Next is subject we, and for we the adjective is our and possessive pronoun will be ours. For you, adjective will be your and possessive pronoun will be yours. For they, adjective will be their and possessive pronoun will be theirs.
Next is reflexive personal pronoun. The reflexive pronouns are myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. A reflexive pronoun refers back to the subject. For example, David did not blame himself for Myra's aggression. The subject is David and the reflexive pronoun himself refers back to David. So in a sentence, reflexive personal pronoun again refers back to the subject present in the sentence. Some more example of reflexive personal pronouns. If everyone is moving forward together, then success takes care of itself. It's a saying by Henry Ford. In this sentence, itself is a kind of reflexive personal pronoun that refers back to the subject, that is success. Next is nature is wont to hide herself. Wont means habit. So nature has a habit to hide herself. Here, herself is a kind of reflexive personal pronoun that is referring back to the subject, that is nature. Now see the fine pictorial example of reflexive personal pronouns. There are two girls, Claire and Aisha. Claire is looking at Aisha. She is looking at her. When the subject and the object are different people, don't use reflexive pronouns. So in a sentence, it is required that when you are using reflexive pronoun, then the subject and object should be same, because reflexive pronoun refers back to the subject. Now another example, Claire is looking at Claire. She is looking at herself. So in second example, there is a mirror and Claire is looking at her reflection in the mirror. So here, herself is a kind of reflexive pronoun that is referring back to Claire in the sentence. So when the subject and the object are the same people, use reflexive pronoun.
Next is demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns are used to demonstrate this, that, these, and those are all demonstrative pronouns. So demonstrative pronouns are used to show the position of anything in a sentence. Examples, this is the one I left in the car. In this example, the speaker could be indicating to a mobile phone, in which case the pronoun this replaces the words mobile phone. So this is a kind of demonstrative pronoun that is used for mobile phone in this example. Next is, shall I take those? In this example, those represent demonstrative pronouns. See other pictorial example, this is my book. Now book is kept near, that's why this demonstrative pronoun is used. Next is, that is my friend. Now friend is standing at a distance, that's why here that demonstrative pronoun is used. Another example, these are my books. Now again, books are showing the position at the nearest place. So these are used as a demonstrative pronoun. Those are my friends. Now friends are standing at a distance. That's why we have used a demonstrative pronoun those in this example. Let's clarify demonstrative pronouns more. A pronoun that points out a person, place, thing or idea through this, that, these and those. So these are the words that showing the position of anything through demonstrative pronoun in sentence. Some examples are, this is the correct answer choice. That was not what you should have said. These are the color choices for the flowers. Those belong to the track coach. Now this, that, these and those used in these sentences are showing the position of different thing used in a sentence. Next is interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are used in questions. Although they are classified as pronouns, it is not easy to see how they replace nouns. Who, which, what, where and how are all interrogative pronouns. So interrogative pronouns are basically question words which are used to ask question. Now see the example, who told you to do that? Now here, who is a kind of interrogative pronoun that is replacing a noun that is not visible in this sentence. So when you get the answer and you get the noun, that noun is replaced by this pronoun who in the form of question. That's why it is interrogative pronoun that is used to ask question. So some examples, who, which, why, when, what, whom, they all comes under interrogative pronoun. Let's see how interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions. First is who. Who comes for people, used as a subject of a verb. Example, who loves spies. Here who is the subject and loves is verb, and who is used as the subject of a verb. Next is, who won yesterday? Now here, who is an interrogative pronoun that is used as the subject of a verb, won in this sentence. Next is whom. Whom is used for people and as the object of a verb or preposition. Example, you saw whom. Saw is verb and whom is an object, and whom is used as the object of the verb saw in this sentence. Next example is, you went with whom. Now here went is verb, with is preposition and whom is an object. And here whom is used as the object of the preposition with. Next category is whose. Whose is used for people and for possession. See the example, whose is this? Whose are those tickets? Now in both the question, the possession is asked that who is having the possession on those tickets. Next is what. What comes for people and used for animal or thing. Now see the example, what is that? What do you mean? So it is asking the question by using the interrogative pronoun what. Next is which. Which comes for people, animals and things. Which is smarter? Which is faster? Which is heavier? Now these all examples includes people, animals and thing. Next type is indefinite pronouns. Unlike demonstrative pronouns which point out specific items, indefinite pronouns are used for non-specific things. This is the largest group of pronouns: all, some, any, several, anyone, nobody, each, both, few, either, none, one, and no one are the most common. So indefinite pronouns are used to denote non-specific thing in a sentence. See some examples. Somebody must have seen the driver leave. Here, somebody is not a specific person that is used as an example of indefinite pronoun. Next is, we are all in the gutter, but some of us are looking at the stars. Here, all and some are the examples of indefinite pronouns that are used for non-specific things. Next example, I have nothing to declare except my genius. Nothing again is showing some non-specific thing. Now see a pictorial example of indefinite pronoun. Everybody is blaming somebody, but nobody is trying to understand anybody. Now here, all examples of indefinite pronouns are showing non-specific things that are everybody, somebody, nobody, and anybody. Indefinite pronouns include compound words of some, any, no, and every. So, an indefinite pronoun is a pronoun that does not refer to a specific person, place, thing, or idea. Some indefinite pronouns are compound words of some, any, no, and every. Here is a chart given including people, things, and places, and different category of indefinite pronouns are used. So, we take first category of some. For people, we can use someone and somebody. For things, something. And for place, somewhere as an indefinite pronoun can be used. Next is any. For people, we can use anyone and anybody. For things, anything. And for places, anywhere can be used as an indefinite pronoun. Next is no. For people, no one and nobody is used as an indefinite pronoun. For things, nothing. And for places, nowhere. Next category is every. For people, we can use the indefinite pronoun in every category as everyone, everybody. For things, everything. And for places, everywhere. How do we use these indefinite pronoun in sentence? Let's take one example of some. So the example is, someone was sitting on the sofa. Can you do something to help? So in first sentence, we are using indefinite pronouns to show the people, that is not a specific. And in second example, we are showing a non-specific thing by using the indefinite pronoun something. Now relative pronouns. Relative pronouns are used to add more information to a sentence. Which, that, who, and where are all relative pronoun, including whom and whose. So for giving more information to a sentence, we use relative pronouns. Let's see examples. Dr. Adam Sisson, who lectured at Cambridge for more than 12 years, should have known the difference. In this example, the relative pronoun who introduced the clause who studied at Cambridge for 12 years and refers back to Dr. Adam Sisson. So who here has come for Dr. Adam Sisson, that is giving extra information about doctor. Next is, the man who first saw the comet reported it as a UFO. In this example, the relative pronoun who introduces the clause who first saw the comet and refers back to the man. So who is an example of relative pronoun here, which is giving extra information that who saw the comet, and that is man. Let's see more relative pronouns, their uses with the example. First is who. Who refers to people and act as a subject of the verb. Example is, he who overcomes his anger subdues his greatest enemy. Who is a relative pronoun here, that is referring back to he and acting as a subject of the verb. Next is whom. Refers to people and objects of the verb. Example is, she's the woman whom I met in Greece. Whom is a relative pronoun here that is referring back to she and acting as an object of the verb. Next is whose. Refers to possession. And example is, whose are these keys? Now this whose relative pronoun is asking about the possession over the keys. Next is which. Refers to animals and objects. And the example is, that is not good language which all understand not. Next is that. Refers to people, thing, and animals. It is a poor mouse that has no hole. Here, that is referring back to the poor mouse.
Where refers to places. Example is, sign your name on the form where I have put a cross. So, where is showing the place of a cross. Next is when, refers to time. Let's cross the bridge when we come to it. So, it is showing the time at that we are going to come on the bridge. Next is why, refers to reason. I would like to know the reason why you are so late. And the last is what, refers to things. Pardon me, I didn't hear what you said. So these are the uses of different relative pronouns in a sentence.
Next type is reciprocal pronouns. Reciprocal pronouns are used for action or feelings that are reciprocated. The reciprocal pronouns are each other and one another. So reciprocated means when the same actions or feelings are exchanged from both sides. Examples, they like one another. Here, some peoples are there who are sharing the same feeling for one another. Next is, they talk to each other like they are babies. Here, we are talking about the two persons who are taking the same actions for each other.
Or whom. Hence, we use reciprocal pronouns when each of two or more subjects is acting in the same way towards the other. There are only two reciprocal pronouns and they are both two words that are each other and one another. Let's see some example based on these words. Mary and John gave each other gold rings on their wedding day. So this is the same gesture showing by the both side. Next is Ram and Meera were talking to each other in the hallway. Means both were talking. The same gestures is being shown by both side. We give each other gifts during the holidays. Again, each other is a kind of reciprocal pronoun. Next example is the students congratulated one another after giving practice speeches. And the last one, the kids spent the afternoon kicking the ball to one another.
Next type is intensive or emphatic pronouns. An intensive pronoun refers back to another noun or pronoun in the sentence to emphasize it. It is a pronoun that adds emphasis to a noun or pronoun already named, and it can be removed from the sentence and the sentence will still make sense. So basic purpose of intensive pronoun is to put emphasis on the noun or pronoun of the sentence. And if we take this intensive pronoun out of the sentence, it still is going to be make sense by the sentence. See some examples. Devin himself gave the speech during the assembly. Here, himself is a intensive pronoun that is used just after the noun Devin. And if we take this intensive pronoun out of the sentence, then still sentence is going to be make sense like Devin gave the speech during the assembly. Next example, we ourselves are responsible for our actions. Next is, we saw Jewels herself at the mall before her concert. So, herself is an intensive pronoun that is coming just after the Jewel. And if we take this intensive pronoun out of the sentence, then still the sentence is going to be make sense. And the last example is, I myself will always be dependable. Here, myself is an example of intensive pronoun. Now see the use of intensive pronouns according to the person. For first person, we use the intensive pronoun myself. For second person, yourself. For third person, himself, herself, itself. For first person plural, ourselves. For second person plural, yourselves. And for third person plural, themselves. If you have remembered, we have gone through with the same example in reflexive pronouns also. So now we are going to see the difference between intensive and reflexive pronouns.
Here is given the difference between intensive and reflexive pronoun. First, we are having intensive and then reflexive. Intensive pronouns add emphasis, whereas reflexive pronouns refers back to the subject. Next is, intensive pronouns are not essential to the meaning of a sentence, whereas reflexive pronouns are essential to the meaning of a sentence. Next difference is, intensive pronouns are not used in sentences where the subject and object refers to the same,
And reflexive pronouns are used in a sentence when the subject and the object are the same. And the last difference is intensive pronouns cannot act as the object of the sentence, whereas reflexive pronouns act as the object of a sentence. At last we came on antecedents. Pronouns are versatile. The pronoun, it can refer to just about anything like a bike, a tree, a movie, a feeling. That's why you need an antecedent. An antecedent is a noun or noun phrase that you mention at the beginning of a sentence or a story and later replace with a pronoun. So antecedent is nothing but a noun or a noun phrase in a sentence that is replaced by a pronoun. Let's see the example. Two sentences are given in the example and both are related. Let's see first sentence. I hate my Russian doll. Here I is a pronoun and my is a type of possessive determiner that is also called possessive pronoun. And I and my are representing the speaker because they are first person pronoun. And Russian doll is a noun. Now, see the next sentence. She is so full of herself. Now she represent Russian doll. So Russian doll will be an antecedent of she, and herself represent she. So she will be an antecedent of herself. So in these two examples, we are having two antecedent. One is noun and one is pronoun. So Russian doll is a noun, that is the antecedent of she, and she is a pronoun, that is the antecedent of herself. There is an agreement between pronoun and antecedent, and here are some rules which shows that how the pronoun and antecedent are agree with each other. Rule number one, all pronouns have antecedents. An antecedent is the word which the pronoun replaces. See the example, Barbara rode her bike home from school. In this example, the antecedent for her is Barbara, and she is the person to whom the word her refers. Rule number two, a pronoun agrees with its antecedent in number and gender. Use a singular pronoun to replace a singular antecedent. For example, the dog wagged tail. Now, since the dog is a singular noun, so it will come and not there. So the example will be the dog wagged its tail. Next, use a plural pronoun to replace a plural antecedent. Example is the salespeople sold own merchandise. Now salespeople is showing a plural noun. So there will come in this sentence, and the sentence will be the salespeople sold their own merchandise. Next, a pronoun must agree with its antecedent in both number, like singular and plural, and gender, like masculine, feminine, and neuter. For example, Jane regained her confidence after a few lessons. Here, Jane is the antecedent of her, that is a singular feminine pronoun. Next example, the cubs searched for their mother. Here, cubs in an antecedent of their, that is a plural neutral pronoun.
So here we have completed a pronoun part. I tried to make you understand with lots and lots of example. That's it for now. We'll meet again.